with their friends, girl, you got it.
Happy Monday, guys. And we're starting off our week with a little exercise. We're on the river. I don't know why I'm singing. We are on the river. Easter was great. Easter was great. I'm still tired, as you can see. But I decided not to get back into bed. I said, move. You know, it feels great outside. It's not hot, it's not cold. It feels wonderful. So I decided to come outside and hopefully nobody, no birds or nothing bother me. I don't like birds. So yeah, I'm still gonna walk a little bit. And then I need to go to the grocery store, so I'm gonna walk there. Not walk there, but you know, I have to walk in there throughout the grocery store. And I need to go to like Walmart or something. So I'm only gonna be out here maybe 30 minutes. And I'm gonna leave. But it's so beautiful, y'all. It's so clean. Let me show you. Actually, I'm a little too close to the water for me. Look, it's so calm. I love coming out here. Hopefully, when I retire from working, I live along the river. This is where I want to retire at. So, it's so calm. We at Target to grocery shop, so we're going to be here for a while. I'm trying to burn time until Lear get out of school at 5. Anyway, so... Let's get on this Target. Lots of kids to the park. Well, just them two. You just not play drums. I know drums too. I'm ready. Oh my God. Take your time. That's crazy. Go on, Mary.
Now watch out.
She'll gotta watch out. Go. Mr. Amazing. Now you stuck. Now let me get you. Wait, don't do nothing because you're gonna hurt yourself. Hey y'all. I'm so tired. I didn't put the bunny down backwards. Today is Monday, April the 1st. We don't play any jokes around here because ain't shit funny. So don't expect no shit like that from me. I got to stop coming on her like this. Because if I meet my husband for real and he find my vlogs, he gonna already see the ugly. And I got no earrings on. Hold on. I'll be right back. Okay. Because I can do a lot of things. But not wear lip gloss and earrings. I can't do that. Anyway, that's not what I came here to talk to y'all about. I came here to say hey, because I don't do as much talking as I have done before. The last vlog, I hardly even vlogged for Easter, and we had an amazing time. Easter was great. Bachelorette update. My roster is back down to zero. I have not had a zero roster in years. Like, it's been a while. No one's calling my phone. I haven't got texts. Like, my phone is quiet. I know it's my mom or my sister or maybe Destiny and somebody's texting me. I know it's not. I'm not looking forward to a man calling or nothing. Like, you know, that's where I'm at. I can't believe I'm here. I haven't been single like this in a long time. I have been single for 3 years as far as in a committed relationship. I have not been in a committed relationship in 3 years. And I'm proud of me. I'm not looking forward to nothing. I'm not expecting nothing from nobody. Nobody shouldn't be expecting nothing from me. I feel very free. I don't feel lonely yet. This is new. I'm tapping into myself. I'm learning more about myself. And this is what I need because I'm different now. But I had to realize, like, I'm not hurt anymore. So, I'm not going to say I'm looking forward to the ride. I'm just going to say I'm going to be here for it. I'm going to be 100% locked in to the ride, keeping my boundaries and my standards and my morals high.
Now, this is what I'm wondering. I'll do this for you.
Oh, thank you so much.
I know you heard me talking.
You don't want to see what I said. You're too cold in this year.
You gotta find somebody to make it work. Them all ain't gotta be cooked. They ain't already done.
Stay free. If they can do that, I'll do it.
I just want to let y'all know I made it home. I took a few shots, so I just want to let y'all know that I made it home. But as I was parking, I got to get my hair back in shape. But as I was parking, I realized that I have an old car, so I don't have like the backup camera or nothing. And I remembered me being in driver's ed in high school, and I scored a perfect score to the point where I did not have to take the driver's test to get my license. I just took my certificate and I just got my license. And I thought that was normal until, you know, I see so many people fail the driver's test and stuff. And I just want to say, like, I'm a perfect driver. I've never been in a wreck. None of that. Like, I have free speeding tickets, but I've never wrecked a car. Like, I'm really a perfect driver. I never had to be taught how to drive. But I just realized, like, out of all of the years I've been driving, I've never had a wreck or nothing like that. I've never hit anyone or hit anything. I hit a squirrel before, so I'm lying. I hit a squirrel. But, you know, the normal things that people do, never been a fender bender. But that's about it. I think I'm a perfect driver. Is that common? Are you a perfect driver? Leave it in the comments. Like, have you never been in a wreck? Like, is not being in a wreck a common thing? Or do everybody get in wrecks? Like, everybody I know been in a wreck. Everybody I know wrecked their car somehow. I've damaged cars, but not from wrecks. Is that not normal? But I'm gonna find me something to eat and go to bed. I'm gonna get up in the morning. I purposely left Lyric with her daddy, so I'm gonna have to get up because I knew I wanted to have fun tonight. And I did. I had fun. So I'm gonna get in bed, and I'm finna snack on me something to eat. Some ice cream or some cereal. I don't know. Salad. I don't really want a salad. I know, but I'm gonna talk to y'all later. I had somebody tell me that they enjoy my vlogs because I be comfortable and I come on here like looking any kind of way. It scares you? I put my best motherfucking foot forward on her. How dare you?
Read out loud.
Good morning. Uh-huh. I'm very excited to share with you that your scholar's optional application has been approved for the 2024-2025 school year.
Scroll down and see the school. You got in. That's crazy. You got in. Give me five. Give me your grades good. Flynn, where have you been? Hey, y'all. We back with the puff. This is my favorite. A lot of people don't like it, but a lot of people can't pull off and where they natural hair. Mine is lopsided. It seems like I have. Okay, I was recording on my other phone and it died. I don't know how I can't keep two phones charged. I don't know. I didn't even know it was dead. But anyway. Anywho, I've been trying to take quiet time. I have a lot of alone time because my daughter goes to school. But I don't take quiet time. I don't take inner me time. And that's what I'm about to start doing. Okay. Growing up, I was raised in a Christian household. In both of the homes that I was raised in, I was raised in Christian households. So we were taught to not believe in magic or anything of the magic realm, which they put horoscopes in also because of the psychic tone of horoscopes. I hope I'm saying all this right, but. And I say all that to say, this is why it means something to me. I just was telling y'all how I know that I need to start back taking quiet. Well, I need to take quiet time instead of a long time. I need to merge the two of them. I've always taken a long time, but it's never been quietly in silence or nothing like that. Now, this is a lady on YouTube that I watch. She's the only one that I watch. Listen to what she's about to say. Okay, this is only a minute in, so I just started watching it. It's about Capricorns, and it's what is meant for you to hear at this exact moment. And the card she pulled has an alligator on it, so she's giving knowledge about the American alligator. So after that, she goes into the explanation of the card, and I didn't hear the whole thing. I stopped, but we're about to listen to the whole thing now.
I use wetlands or any brackish water. We have them in our bayous down here, okay? The holes alligators build to lurk in.
Let me speed up a little bit.
Plain. And we feel like some of you guys may be in that energy of just possibly in a moment of solitude and silence, seclusion, okay? And you're being told here, Capricorn, that that silence and seclusion are your greatest teachers here, okay? Not from this book, but I'm just telling you that, okay, it is your greatest teacher, this silence and seclusion. Spirit is saying being alone can lead to introspection and renewal. It can make you strong, most definitely, okay? And bring about an immense amount of awareness and clarity to your mind, your body, and your spirit. But they're saying too much isolation can bring with it a kind of slowness or stagnation in your life, which I don't want that for you. Mm. Things to be slowing down, just trickling in, okay?
Now, let me talk about why that is so powerfully confusing. I get more from those readings than I ever have in church, as far as reaching me, as far as I feel like it's for me. Like, so that's a battle for me. I love God, but I was taught to. I never had a choice of loving anything else. But what if, because no way, what I just said to y'all, she just said the same thing. I promise, this is my first time watching it. It just loaded 16 hours ago. I was going to watch it yesterday, but I didn't feel well. And I went to sleep early. I had a client, like, I don't watch it when I have clients. This is something I only watch alone. And there's just no way how I feel is what she just said within the first 5 minutes. And that does not scare me. That draws me nearer. Like, I don't know. I don't really know. Because I don't even know what avenue to go down to hop into. Am I a spiritualist? I don't know, y'all. But I just thought that was crazy. I don't know. I'm going to talk to y'all later.
Hi.
I'm gonna shout somebody out, but I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna ask if I can get his permission first before I do. I'm gonna talk to him first. We gotta.
Thank you.
Okay, y'all. Today's Saturday, April 6th, I think. And y'all want to hear something not funny? Well, I'm outside fixing my car. So, this the terminal. This the thing that the wires go into, and then it fits on it. So, I got to put those wires back into this. Yeah. How I'm going to do this? How I'm going to do this? So, I'm unscrewing. And y'all know I be losing stuff. I be forgetting what I'm doing. Like, the phone's sitting on it. Hold on. One of the downfalls of maybe poverty and growing up in a single parent household, for sure, is being an independent woman. And I guess it depends on how you see it, if it's a downfall or not. But for me, it's a downfall. Like, I always try to figure stuff out myself, because honestly, most things are just like a puzzle. And I love puzzles. Most things are just like a puzzle. If you stop and analyze and take your time and look and see what you got, you almost can figure out how to do it yourself. You almost can figure out how to do it yourself. And you know, my mama always taught us to pay attention to detail. And that's just who I am now. So okay, so I got it bigger now. See how it's open? So I'm gonna try to put these in here. Boom, they fit. Take this glove on and I'm crazy. I got him in there now. I'm about to tighten it back up, put it back on, and see if the car starts. Okay. I think I got one side tightened. Now I'm finishing this one. Oh, I got both of them tight. Both of them tight. See, they're not coming out. We're gonna put it back on here. Now the thing is, last night I lost a penny. My sister, daddy had put a penny in here for me because this thing been giving me trouble for like a year. Hey! Now you know, I ain't gonna ask a nigga to do nothing for me.
I stopped. I made my own tattoo. Huh? My own shit. I don't want you to
Uh-huh.
I'm a cop.
Yeah, I just figured this shit out on my own.
I go to the mechanic and get my arm changed.
That's it? Yeah. And if y'all didn't already know, I'm having a hair emergency. That kid out here put in my hair did not revert. But in the meantime, let's see if the car starts. It started. My cycle late. I'm stressed.
So pretty, baby girl, you are so pretty.